How did the famous investor, co-founder of Facebook, and multi-billionaire Peter Thiel get rich? Find out in today's episode.
My name is Dan Henry, and when I was 16 years old, I decided that I wanted to be rich. So I studied as many wealthy entrepreneurs as I could and used what I learned to create my own successful business. The purpose of this channel is to share my research with the world and show you how they got rich.
Peter Thiel is a large presence in business and American politics, a man who has played a major role in the development of some of today's largest corporations. According to Forbes, his net worth surpasses $2 billion. How does such wealth happen? For Thiel, it began in Frankfurt am Main, Germany, on October 11, 1967. At the time, the country was divided by what was once called the Iron Curtain, and the Thiel family called West Germany home. Political realities for the family were never far away, geographically as well as mentally. Communism loomed close. Peter was a year old when the Thiels emigrated to the United States. They settled for a short time in Cleveland, Ohio, where Peter's father worked as a chemical engineer. During this period, Peter's mother applied for American citizenship, something her husband did not do. Klaus, Peter's father, then took to working for numerous mining companies in the countries of South Africa and Namibia. It was an itinerant life for the family. Those years required young Peter and his younger brother Patrick to change schools often. One of them, in coastal Namibia, subjected him to a level of conformity and physical discipline that shaped his later views. Peter did not want to wear a school uniform every day, and he rebelled against corporal punishment, such as teachers striking students' hands with rulers. All of these elements, awareness of communism, rejection of conformity for conformity's sake, and physical punishment, were beginning to shape Thiel's deeply held political views. The family finally settled in Foster City, California in 1977. It was there that Thiel's love of mathematics led him to win first place in a statewide math competition while he was in middle school. As he moved into high school, his reading habits grew beyond his early love of J.R.R. Tolkien to include works by Ayn Rand, founder of the philosophy Objectivism. More than that, Ayn Rand also was a Russian expatriate, having emigrated in the early days of communism, the 1920s, to the United States. Her embrace of political freedom and rejection of collectivist thinking attracted Thiel. This was in the mid-1980s, and Ronald Reagan became a hero of Thiel's. The president was optimistic, especially about the US, and he was anti-communist in the extreme. Against the background of personal and intellectual development, Thiel was excelling in his studies. Upon graduating high school in 1985, he received his diploma as valedictorian of his class. Thiel attended Stanford University studying philosophy. He was also active in political debate. Because of what he saw as a growing liberal trend on campus, reflected in what new courses were beginning to be offered and what older ones were being dropped, he founded the Stanford Review, a newspaper that was conservative and libertarian, the political stance he now took. After undergraduate school, Thiel enrolled in Stanford Law School. He earned his Doctor of Jurisprudence degree in 1992 and then worked for the United States Court of Appeals for the 11th Circuit. Later, he went to New York to work as a securities lawyer at international law firm Sullivan & Cromwell. He left after 7 months to become a derivatives trader at Credit Suisse. While there, he began speechwriting for former U.S. Secretary of Education William Bennett, a noted and outspoken conservative. But Thiel wasn't happy. He wanted to return to California, and he wanted work that he could consider meaningful. He translated meaningfulness, or transcendence as it was taught him at Stanford, as work that an individual engages in not so much to become better than anyone else at a given occupation, but as an expression of his or her talent and motivation. Originating in early 19th century philosophy, transcendence sees people acting their best when they're self-reliant. With this in mind, he moved to the San Francisco Bay Area. It was 1996, and the dot-com boom was in its early days. Using a combined $1 million from his savings and that of friends and family, he began a venture capital career as head of the new Thiel Capital Management. This was the beginning of Thiel's personal wealth boom. A 1998 investment in a startup called Confinity resulted in his partnering with Luke Nosek and Max Levchin to create what became known to the world as PayPal. Because not all online merchants had the hardware necessary to accept all credit cards, the three thought that a digital wallet, which was safe to use online, would be a boon to online business. And they were right. PayPal benefited from a March 2000 merger with Elon Musk's X.com. And when eBay bought PayPal in 2002 for $1.5 billion, Thiel, who had remained CEO until the sale and owned 3.7% of the company's stocks, received a cool $55 million. Thiel suffered some losses in a firm he created, Clarium Capital Management, at the start of the Great Recession of 2008 to 2009, but he had started another company years before that would deliver in a big way. Around the time of the September 11th, 2001 terrorist attacks, Thiel started to wonder if PayPal's mechanisms to fight financial fraud could be applied to fighting terrorism. He thought about whether Americans would rather have more security with less privacy or the opposite. The company he founded in early 2003, Palantir Technologies, named after the fictional communication device in Tolkien's world, provides data mining services to government intelligence agencies. Palantir's first investor was InQtel, the venture capital arm of the Central Intelligence Agency. Its stated mission is providing national security, and its goal is to do so while remaining traceable and without being intrusive. Palantir has grown since its early days. In 2015, it was valued at $20 billion. Thiel continues as its chairman and is its largest shareholder. Thiel was the inventor of another startup that he thought might succeed. In 2004, he was introduced to a young entrepreneur named Mark Zuckerberg, who told him about a brainchild he had hatched at Harvard, one he wanted to introduce to the world. Thiel decided to invest $500,000 in Facebook, and it was an investment that paid off handsomely. By selling shares at times he judged opportune, he has taken in more than $1 billion in the last decade, and he still owns about 60,000 shares. Thiel's activity in business has remained steady in the area of venture capital investments, but he continues his interest in technology and national security. Other investments include private companies such as Airbnb, Stripe, and Vivint. On top of his considerable business activity, though, he has created a reputation for political involvement, reflecting the views he developed since he was a defiant middle schooler. He had remembered the place of his birth and its proximity to totalitarian government, and his self-education by way of reading, together with his formal education, shaped deeply held political views. Those views were further honed by debate and by articulating them in the newspaper he founded and was editor-in-chief of until his graduation. As a wealthy and politically aware business leader, Thiel has dedicated much of his attention to philanthropic activities, including artificial intelligence, life extension, and the Committee to Protect Journalists, which seeks to protect and defend freedom of the press. All of his political influence was made possible by his success as an entrepreneur and business builder. Multiple billions of dollars of financial worth allows him to wield influence that was unavailable to him before he made his fortune. Peter Thiel's love of the fantasy world of J.R.R. Tolkien has led him to name his companies after details from Middle-earth. He is known these days, among other things, for investing $500,000 in Facebook, one of the biggest companies on planet Earth. The son of an itinerant mining engineer who became one of the world's 2,000 billionaires remains active as a venture capitalist and continues his work in technology. His future net worth only promises to grow.
Hey, Dan Henry here, and I hope you enjoyed this episode of How They Got Rich. I created this channel because these men and women inspired me to quit my job years ago as a pizza boy and pursue entrepreneurship, which eventually led me to become a multi-millionaire. If you'd like to know more about that, you can follow me on my main YouTube channel, youtube.com/Dan Henry. But before you go, I'd like to remind you why the people on this channel are successful, as well as myself. It's because they've mastered three main areas of their life: business, productivity, and mindset. And that's why I've made it my life's work to help others in those three key areas. So here are three ways I can help you right now. If you own a business and you're looking to grow it, you can head over to getclients.com and learn how we built a $20 million business, as well as learn how these strategies can apply to your business. You'll find a collection of free trainings, podcasts, and blog posts on that website to help you grow your business. As well, you can grab a free copy of my book, Digital Millionaire Secrets, which is a Wall Street Journal and USA Today bestseller. You can find that on getclients.com. Number two, you can head over to plantomorrow.com and check out the Plan Tomorrow Daily Planner. This is a planner I personally designed to make myself more productive and get things done. Because the truth is, if you want to do big things, you have to get things done. And I know this planner will help change your life like it's changed mine. For a limited time, it also comes with a free productivity class taught by me. So head over there right now and grab yourself a copy. And finally, number three, if you're struggling with mindset, confidence, motivation, imposter syndrome, or you're just looking to develop a rock solid mindset so you can achieve more in life, then I want you to head over to howtothink.com, where we have daily mindset mentoring on how to achieve anything in life by changing the way you think. So grab a copy of your Plan Tomorrow Daily Planner now. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next episode.